Hi, I'm Christine Niles. I wanted to address the resignation of Michael Voris. And for those who may be unaware of what's going on, I will first start out by reading the official statement issued by Church Militant. Also, I've been dealing with a persistent cough, so my apologies if my voice is a little bit hoarse. Fellow Catholics, Church Militant St. Michael's Media was founded as a bastion of Catholic truth and a light to the faithful in hard times. This is why we are being fully transparent with you all. Michael Voris has been asked to resign for breaching the Church Militant morality clause. The board has accepted his resignation. We understand this is a shock to you all, but our founder and former CEO is stepping aside and focusing on his personal health. The board of directors has chosen not to disclose Michael's private matters to the public. The apostolate will be praying for him, and we kindly ask you to do the same. Church Militant St. Michael's Media is just as positioned to save souls as it ever has been. There are more than 40 full-time employees on the cutting edge of Catholic truth, moving forward with renewed fervor. The apostolate will remain unwavering in its reporting and its commentary, defending Holy Mother Church from errors both inside and out. We appreciate your continued support and prayers. God love you, Church Militant. First of all, I hope that you will continue to support the good souls working at Church Militant, because there are many, many, many good souls still working at Church Militant. I, as many of you know, left Church Militant on November 10th. That was my last day. I actually submitted my letter of resignation on November 9th. It was a detailed letter that I submitted to the board of directors and some people in leadership, explaining my concerns with the environment at Church Militant. I'm not going to go into all the details of that letter, but I will simply say that I had been concerned for quite some time about the direction in which the apostolate was heading, that it was far afield from the original mission of Church Militant. I came to Church Militant in 2014, so I had been there for almost 10 years, a long time. I poured my heart and my soul into that apostolate. It was everything to me. I worked very hard, and I will always be grateful for everything that I learned there, the time that I spent there. I'll be grateful for Michael Voris's mentorship and the things I learned there. I learned so many things, acquired so many new skills, which I hope to be able to use in the future for good. Now, I do want to make very clear that if you are hoping that I'll divulge private details about this breach of the morality clause, that's not happening. That's not happening in this video. I will respect Michael Voris's privacy. If he wants to address that in more detail, that is his decision. I'm not in the business of detraction. I simply wanted to address questions about my leaving. And like I said, there were lots of troubling things over the past year, but especially over the past several months, about the direction in which Church Militant was heading and some of the decisions that Voris was making. And quite frankly, his personality change. He is not the man that I came to work for in 2014. Quite frankly, the lack of prayer with the staff. And that is something that I will reveal, that Voris basically had not been praying with the staff for about 2 years. And that right there is a massive warning sign. I remember when I first came to Church Militant, he was diligently leading us in morning and evening prayer, leading the daily rosary, going to daily mass. And it was mandatory for all of us to be in morning and evening prayer and praying the rosary. And like I said, he was leading all of that. And I was so very grateful, just as the rest of the staff were grateful. But somewhere along the line, over the past several years, it just became less and less of a priority, to the point where, you know, it got to the point where we just basically never saw him. He never saw me. He popped in maybe for an hour or 2 hours to take care of business, shoot the vortex, do various other things, and then he was gone. I don't know how many times Voris has said in many of his talks, the first sign that someone is going to fall is you stop praying. How many times has he said that in talks, you know, referring to maybe a public leader, a public Catholic leader, a priest who may have fallen? He said, oh yeah, the first sign was they stopped praying. You have to pray, especially in this business that we're in. especially if you're involved in a Catholic apostolate where you're taking on such powerful people and you're exposing so much corruption, you absolutely must be covered in prayer. Absolutely. It's something I always tell my children. It is your spiritual force field. When you pray that daily rosary, when you pray any of these prayers, and it's got to be a discipline. It can't just be sort of random prayers that you pray here and there. It's got to be a daily regimen and a discipline. If you don't have that in your life, particularly in this business, this job that we're doing of saving souls, which involves exposing corruption and going up against very, very powerful and dark forces, my goodness, that's it. You're lost. It is game over. It is game over. You must pray and you must never stop praying. And like I said, it can't be simply perfunctory prayers that you say here and there. It has to be a regimen, a serious regimen of prayer. It is a spiritual battle at the end of the day. And I have a very, very keen sense of that. I always have, even more so now. I mean, if there is any lesson to be learned from this, it is that you can never stop praying. What does scripture say? The devil, you know, you must be vigilant because the devil prowls around like a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. We must be always vigilant in our prayer life. If we are not, we are lost. And this especially applies to people involved in public Catholic ministry. To say that I am heartbroken and furious is an understatement, okay? There's a lot of anger. There's a great deal of anger over this. Forgiveness, of course. Who has not fallen? And we do not have the right to judge because you don't know if you would have done better in his circumstances. We don't have the right to judge. That doesn't mean, though, that it hasn't harmed a lot of people. It hasn't scandalized a lot of people and that it hasn't hurt a lot of good people still at Church Militant, which is why I encourage you to please continue to support them. I myself am going freelance. I'm doing my own freelance work, reporting, investigative journalism, video editing, and that sort of thing. I am more than happy to continue to work with Church Militant in the future if they'd like to work with me. I'm certainly not cutting them off, and I hope that you don't either. Above all, pray. Pray for all of us. Pray for Michael Voris. Pray for the staff who are left hurting at Church Militant. And I think that really is the lesson here is you never stop praying. You pray and you lean on God for all things in complete and total humility. All is grace. As St. Therese has said, as St. Augustine has said, all is grace. As soon as we think that we have some goodness or merit of our own, apart from God, that's it. You have to have total and complete and absolute humility, especially in this line of work. All right, thank you so much for listening. God bless you, and please pray for us.